Today I'm going to show you how to do 3D volumetric lights within After Effects. Let's start off by creating a new composition, and I have stock footage here. It's a dark room with a bright window. First of all, we have to track this footage, so we're going to track camera. I have seen a lot of tutorials with volumetric lights, but not within a 3D room where you can control the lights in a 3D space. So today I'm going to show you how I make my 3D volumetric lights. For this, we have to have a camera, so that's why we're tracking this footage. All right, now we're back. We're going to track the wall that has this window. So let's select these points and create null and camera. Okay, let's see. Let's rename the null to null. And just scale it up a bit to see that it's stuck to the wall. Perfect. The next step is to make adjustment layer. And here we're gonna apply levels. And we're gonna crank up the blacks. This. Just to isolate the window. Take the brightest part of the room and up here. Right. The next effect is tint, just to make it black and white. We can change the color later on, but let's make it black and white for now. The next effect is fast radial. Let's see, CC radial fast blur. Apply it, and here's the light beams. As you see, there's a center of the light rays that we can move around, but it's in 2D. And if you change the blending mode on the adjustment layer to screen, you can see that we have nice volumetric lights. But just like I said, it's in 2D, so we have to put an expression on the center of the radial fast blur, so it's gonna follow the stock footage that we track. Okay, so go to fast radial fast blur. Radial fast blur, and press Alt and press Center. And here we're gonna write an expression. Let's see. This comp dot layer parenthesis null dot to comp. Oh, it's a small t like this. And parentheses. And what this expression does is that it takes the values of the three axes from the null and applies it to the 2D values of the center of radial fast blur. And if we move around the null, you can see that the rays follows the null and sticks to the stock footage. And as you see, if you scroll around here, you see that it sticks to the stock footage. Okay, now we can make some adjustments here. We can change the lights to a little bit bluish, tintish kind of light here, like so. We can change the zoom to brightest to make it more visible. So you see, can make it a bit larger, like 93, like so. Perfect. Now imagine if you have like trees or something outside, the light rays that comes into the room, they're gonna move a little bit. So to achieve that, we can make some fractal noise. And if we just change the blending mode on the adjustment layer to normal, just for now, and we hide tint and fast radial blur, we go to fractal noise, blending mode, darken. I'm gonna see some ugly effects here. We can now change the fractal type to, let's see, swirly, maybe. Just scale it down a bit. Oh, not too much, like this. And change the contrast, up the contrast, down with the brightness. To achieve the movement, we have to make the fractal noise move a bit. So we're gonna add an expression here. You press Alt and then Evolution on the time watch, and type time times maybe 50. Okay, let's put the tint back on, radial fast blur back on, and change the blending mode on the adjustment layer to screen again. Now we're gonna see a subtle effect of the light moving. Maybe it's a little too much. Let's lower this value to 25. I want it to have a little subtle effect, not too much. Maybe it's too much anyway. 15 maybe. Yeah. If you like this tutorial, leave a like. If you feel like you can achieve the same effect by doing something else, please leave a comment. It's really nice to have some feedback on what you do. And if you like tutorials like this, subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.